I expect it to do.
Assembling it together from your flight control to your fuel system, heating band, and your oil system. Then after we complete it all, put together, sell it to quality control. Quality control takes care of all the you recording? Recording everything?
Yes, sir.
All your fuel cells are stripped down. On it, all your decks are stripped out, and then we start from very clean cut. We start shimming the engine, and then your transmission, your ducting, all your hydraulic system lines. Anything that's cracked, any bulkhead that's cracked or anything that's unserviceable, we strip it out, we put a new one in there. And we just rebuilt the whole shell. Flight control system, all your connections where they your bell cranks, they're redone also, they're re-greased. The ones that are no good, they replace them right there and immediately. They're for your doors. All that is redone also. All your cables are treated for corrosion. Your instrument panels, all your unit at a time, and we run them through the whole system.
Your elevator. A star is born.
see those guys over there on top? They're folding up a fuel cell. They're gonna put it in. When they do, they fold it up. After they put all your old rings and all your valves, they stick it down inside your fuel cavity. And the fuel tank is also processed through a different shop where they do they check it for leaks. Build the engine, they bring it over here, they put it over here in the middle of they've done all their parts, like when your transmission's been done on a transmission shop, your engine right here is where they put it all together, and then it's sold to quality assurance. Quality assurance and in turn takes it and they either accept it or reject it. And then if it's accepted, it goes to the paint shop, and then the people are gonna go back to its unit. They come and pick it up, check it out, make sure it's all right, and flight test. Then there in turn also they check it up for Coast Guard. We do even some of the different places like Korea bring some of the aircraft down here. Germany brings some of the aircraft down here. Even the Spain government brings their aircraft down here so they can be worked on. We're worldwide. We do everybody. An animal. Turnaround day anywhere from 16 to 20 days. On a H model, on a N model, it takes a little longer, maybe say 4 or 5 days more.
16 to 20 days on a UH-1?
Yeah, a turnaround day when it comes in to when it goes out, the finished product.
Same transmission?
No, you have a different transmission.
Done with this. really want to look in there. You can see what he does when he's doing it with a...
Show you in a little bit what they do when they use the plastic piece.
They do over here is the hand strip, because some of the stuff that they gotta get closer to some of the areas where they do that needs to be stripped out, it's gotta be done by hand. Because some of your closer areas, your closer areas that they need to be stripped by hand. A small brush, they get all the big stuff out. All these guys here are hand strippers, they call them hand strippers.
And it's tagged, this is called the disassembly shop.
Come on over here, you got a bigger area over here, man.
This is where they take the tailbone off, everything is stripped. You gotta strip your rooms. Over here you gotta strip your rooms. Where they strip them out by, and they're being cleaned out, see?
So they stick each unit on top of these, grates here,
uh-huh.
And they use a steam cleaning solution and take off all the grime before they tear them apart and rebuild them.
That's right. That's what they do here. And everything is tagged. Everything from the aircraft is being tagged. That way they know what part is going where and
right.
What belongs to what aircraft. Tagged and put in phrase that way they know what form is where. They're taking it apart right now. They're taking everything out right now of the aircraft. All your panels, everything that the inspector does. How you doing, John?
Pretty good.
Synchronized also at the same time.
Because it's a critical part of the aircraft, your collector stick and your cyclic stick, all that. And they have to check all everything. They check all your gears, make sure none of them are broken. All your teeth on your gears are being checked, make sure nothing is worn out, your bearings, everything is greased in here also.
We got more stuff over here.
Get all the way over there.
out there, so they put them out here.
So you're running out of battery, huh? They test them in here, they pressure them up with 2 pounds of air. That's the more they can go on them. That way they check for leaks and seals and all that stuff.
Come on, send me a used helicopter. Corpus Christi, we got all models. We're blowing them out.
What they do with the shell, they take it in and they rip all the paint off so they can check for any fatigue on all your aluminum, right? And you rib it, sometimes you get corrosion on your rivet, and then there might be a crack underneath the paint. Well, underneath your skin, you know, sometimes you get a little hairline crack. You know, paint a little silver. So what they do is they pick it up and put it down and go right to the metal and look at it. And after they do that, they retreat the whole metal with aluminum, aladine. They treat the whole thing with aluminum. And they make sure that it's treated right so you don't get corrosion again on it. So they start from that. Then after they get that done, they start grounding the part. Everything's supposed to have a traveler on it. That way they know that part goes back to the same aircraft. But they can tell whatever they're going to put new on there, but then they take another traveler and say, well, we need to order this part for this aircraft, and this part needs to be replaced. This is on service, so they junk that one out. The transmission bus, the transmission shop, they open it up.
Thank you.
And then they got another place where they test your blades. It's outside, they run the blades.
Blade test facility.
They can run four blades at a time in there.
Last table. So all the sanding is done here, all the grinding and sanding. Goes down the tables and gets collected. They have some filters in the system that collect all the shavings and dust and everything and sand it off. Over there in that area, that's our bonding room. That's where they do put on all of the pieces, patches, and things of that nature, anything that requires paint shop. The paint shop sends them back to us, and we do the assembly and the balance of the units, and then they go out either to. If they're line support, we put the units together, they go out to the line. If they're supply, then all that goes out is the blades individually. Then he takes the master blade off, put the production blades on, and will calibrate the blades against the fixture. That's for Huey's right there, and Air Force and Navy blades, the 204, the Navy's. The Dash 27s and 25s. In models, that's what we do on that picture. That, and balance the pressure plate against the master. And then it goes in that picture there.
Right.
That goes on that picture there. And that's what we do in balancing the line. And they balance it. And then it's ready to go in the aircraft. Right. Goes outside. Yeah. All of those upstairs here are assigned to an aircraft.
Years back.
We got a project on where they brought three of them. They wanted to find out how long they could run without oil. So what they did, they put it in the test and they ran it. Then they ran all the oil out. And they found out that it could run 36 minutes before everything was locked up.
Thanks. 46 transmission.
This
over here it's separate.
Because when that Dash 10 was built, they built it to or maybe they could run both of them at the same time. Which we only run one.
Once they're built, you have your hits.
This is the preparation side of the paint hanger.